Honorable Senators, I also want to speak at this Black History Month, and I want to showcase the work of young leaders in my own backyard. Over the summer, I had the absolute honor of virtually attending a forum featuring young leaders of African descent in British Columbia. First, Fatima Diri, who spoke about the impact of COVID-19 on young people of African descent. Fatima talked about the impacts she has faced as a small Black business owner, in spite of the challenges she's facing during the pandemic. Fatima reminds us that flowers don't grow without rain. Samantha Musoko shared a moving presentation on the importance of communities building new opportunities for youth of African descent. Samantha highlighted her firsthand experiences of working with youth as well as her own upbringing. Samantha urged all professionals and those in positions of power to ask themselves, and I quote, "What can you do as a person to improve your community?" Close quotations. Mariam Arafiti spoke about the effects COVID-19 has had on young mothers who had been forced to stay at home, either due to the lack of affordable options for childcare, unemployment and loss of unemployment, or all of the above. She wants us to know, and I quote, "What can BC and federal government do for mothers to ease the stress and burden of COVID-19? And what mental health supports are available to her?" Godas Mohazo is a performing musician, an artist. She gave us a glimpse inside the impact 19 has had on musicians and their financial well-being. Amid all these obstacles and uncertainty, she sees her community coming together against racism, and she sees music as one of the things that is going to unify it. Finally, we heard from Lillian Mayombo, a remarkable young woman and an incredibly talented poet. Lillian generously performed two original poems for the forum. I was moved by every word Lillian spoke. I want to leave you all with just one line from the second poem Lillian shared with us. "Together with our leaders, nothing is impossible." Honorable Senators, after hearing these young people's powerful presentations, I am confident that they are the ones who will continue the fight for a brighter future for Canada. Thank you.